Right, Paul, thanks for joining us, and you've got a big grin on your face. What a difference a few wins make.
Yeah, much needed, obviously. I think we've been playing well, but didn't really have the points to show for that. But 2 wins in 5 days, or whatever it was, is certainly leaving us a lot happier.
And the table's looking a lot better as well, and all of a sudden, you know, from kicking around at the bottom, we're not kicking the backside off the playoffs.
Yeah, we're not quite where we want to be, or where we feel we can get to, so yeah, obviously, keep level-headed. We know we've achieved nothing yet. I think we're 6th in the league, and although we're getting better and better, we're still not happy with that. So we've got a long way to go, but we're certainly going the right direction.
I know you won't mind me saying, you've been around the block a wee bit, and you've been here before. You're one of the older heads in the team as well. There's a lot of young boys. It looks like this team's got a lot of growing to do yet, but the early signs are encouraging.
Yeah, there's a lot of potential right through the team. A lot of young boys. I think they're starting to gel as a team. I think the longer you play with each other, boys know what runs other boys are going to make. A lot of continuity there now. It's certainly helped us in recent weeks to have a settled side.
How are you enjoying it as well, obviously, because you joined in the summer. Are you enjoying your role within the squad and the team?
I'm enjoying, obviously, captaining these young boys. I think they've all got bright futures. I think they'll go and have good careers, but it's important that we obviously do well for this club. Climb the league, and once I leave, the boys can go and have a great careers if they want, but as long as they're doing well and doing the business for Dunfermline, that's all that matters.
Let's have a wee chat about the game on Saturday upcoming then. Aloe have already played them a couple of times this season. They've been very, very tight encounters. We know what to expect. You know, they've been struggling a wee bit of late, but it's going to be a tough match through there, isn't it?
Yeah, it's always a tough game. I think seeing them live on TV against Dundee United at their place, and they were outstanding, they were brilliant. Got a lot of good players, we know they'll pose us a lot of problems. I think they've already done that this season. So it'll be another tough game, but it's like every hard game in this division, they're all tough. Be a hard place to go, but I think I'm right in saying we always get a lot of fans there. So we're looking forward to it.
You know, you mentioned this league just seems to throw up surprises every single week. We obviously beat Queen of the South on Saturday, who've beaten Dundee United, who are, you know, look like a really strong outfit this year. It's so tight, this division, isn't it?
It is really tight. You know what, there's, we've only put 2 wins on the board in concession, but that shoots you up the table. Everything's rosier after 2 wins, but if you can do that in this league, put a run of 2, 3, 4, the league quickly changes, and that's obviously something we're looking to do.
You mentioned that a wee bit earlier as well, even though we weren't quite getting the results that we were wanting earlier on in the season, it didn't seem to be that the team spirit was still there, you were still believing in what you were doing. Is it just a case of the team is beginning to gel now and you know, get to know, because there was a lot of change over the summer, wasn't
there? Yeah, there was a lot of changes, a lot of young boys coming in as well. Obviously, not many of the team had played together. So as you say, keeping the same team or the same close group of boys for a number of weeks would definitely help. But you see, everyone's getting better and better. Certain individuals are playing really well at the minute as well, which is boding well for the whole side.
Particularly on Saturday, both goals were really well taken from Ryan Dow and Kevin Nisbet. They've been a thorn in many teams' side this season. They're important players for us, aren't they?
Yeah, I played with Dow at Dundee United. I know exactly how good he is. He's played a lot of games in the SPL. And Nizzy's obviously one that's hoping to come here and shoot himself to the SPL, or ideally shoot the club to the SPL, but certainly he's got to put the pressure on himself to go and become an SPL player again.
And finally, from your point of view, Paul, I guess it's just, you know, you're the figurehead of the team as the captain, and it's just about keeping this run going and getting another 3 points on Saturday before the international break.
As we said, it's going to be a tough game, but we feel we're good enough to win every single game we go into. We've let ourselves down a couple of occasions this year, but on the whole, I think we're starting to show we're a good side. But at the same time, you only become a good side by winning games, and there's a long way to go for us yet. We want to look back at the end of the season and say, you know what, we've done well, and 6th in the league just now isn't where we want to be as a club.